Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. I'm so happy to see you again, and if you're new, hi, hello, my name is Sandra. Don't forget to hit subscribe down there, because then you won't miss any of my uploads in 2018, and I promise you, it's going to be a really, really exciting year, as always. So, today's video is going to be Shop My Stairs, my monthly makeup drawer, and I am so, so excited to pull out some empties from this drawer right now, because I have so much stuff in here and it just get too much when the stuff are empty. So I'm going to take the stuff that are empty first. The first one is this one. This is from L'Oreal and this is the BB powder. You have not seen me pull this in the last video because I have decided to take this in as an extra item to work on in the whole month. And ta-da! It's empty, so I'm so, so happy because this is an older powder to me, so this is out and gone and bye-bye. Then this is gone, and that surprised me a lot because I thought I had a lot more in it than I had, but yeah, this is completely gone. I don't have anything else in it, and I have scraped the sides a lot and tried to get everything out, so this is completely empty, and this is the Red and White Photo Focus Foundation, if you are wondering. So for a replacement for that foundation, I took in this H&M Cushion Foundation, and this is also empty. Yeah, that is surprising too, because I don't feel like I've used this a lot. So I know now I'm not a big fan of cushion foundation, because they don't last a long, long time. So this one is going out too. And now I'm going to let all my project pans items stay, and I have decided to split them in some categories. So I have all my nail polish over here, they are staying, and this little corner right here is all my project pans items, or my rolling project pans items, so they are staying in here, and I got some of my mini madness project pans item in here. So they're all over the place right now, and I'm trying to find a way to organize it in here so it doesn't get in the way when I'm filming my videos. We will see how I can do it, but for now this is going to be like this. But the two first rows, or two first section right here, is always my nail polish and my project pan and my rolling project pan item. So that is just that. Then I got this little pot, and there are some foundation in it, and this is a customized foundation. I have done a mixing all your foundation together. I'm going to leave it up here or up here, I cannot remember, so you can see how that went, because that was really, really exciting. So I'm going to let this stay and try to work on it, and same go with this one. This is also a little pot of foundation. Then I got my NYX blush in the shade Angel. I'm going to take this out, along with my Sleek Cream to Powder blush in the shade French Rose. This is such a stunning color, but I need to have something else to work on. Then we got this one. This is a H&M eyeshadow in the shade Bacardi Dama. I really, really like this shade. Oh, I need to find an angle. I have decided to take another angle today because I feel like this is more convenient for you to see everything, but I need to find a way to show you. Oh yeah, right there. You can see I've used this a ton, so I'm going to take it out, and I really, really like this for my more natural days. I'm going to take these two ColourPop Zinger eyeshadow out. I got it in Millionaire and in Supermodel. I've used both of them, and I have pan in Supermodel, so I'm so, so excited. Then I'm going to take this one out. This is my ColourPop Super Shock Chic highlighter in the shade Flexitarian, and I also hit pan in this one. This is such a stunning highlighter. So if you are a pearl or light like me, then take this one. This is such a stunning highlighter, and it's so reflective, so yeah, amazing. Then we got my powder, and this powder has been in my drawer for the last 2 months. So I'm going to take it out and take a break from it, because there's a ton of product in this Laura Mercier powder, and you can never get to the bottom in this. So I'm going to take it out for now, but I'm going to pull it in a month or two again, but for now I'm going to take it out. Then we got this one. This is my Red and White Mega Glow Contouring Palette, and this is Dutch Lace palette, and I don't like this right now, so I'm going to take it out, because I feel like this is a more summery color for me when it comes to this setting powder and this contour slash bronzing powder. So I'm going to take this out for now. I'm going to let this stay, because I really, really like this. This is the New Bay cream moisturizer, and this is such a good moisturizer for priming your skin, not just moisturize before primer and everything, so I'm going to let this stay. Along with this hashtag InstaFix and Go 2-in-1 priming and setting spray from Rimmel, and this is almost empty. So yeah, I'm going to let this stay and work on this and maybe have this and empty the next month. This one, my loved Wet n Wild highlighter in the Swedish Bling. I really, really like this highlighter and have used this a couple of times, but I'm going to pull it out for now. Then we got this one. This is my Cover All palette from Wet n Wild, and I love this so freaking much, you know that. So this is staying. Then we got an eyelash curler. I'm just going to remove that. My Tarte Shape Tape Concealer is going down really, really quick, and that surprised me because I feel like I have a ton of product in this one, but still it's going down really, really fast. But I'm going to let this stay and work on this. I'm going to let this the Real Mascara from Benefit stay because this is in my mini matte project pan. I'm going to let the lip gloss from Dior stay because this is from my rolling project pan. Then we got this one. This is my Guerlain mascara, and I think I'm going to pull this out in the middle of March because I don't know how long this has been open, maybe 2 or 3 months now, and I know you cannot have an open mascara for too long, so yeah. But it's still wet and it doesn't smell bad or anything, so I'm going to let this stay maybe the half of the month and then pull it out. I'm going to let my Milani Big and Bigger Lashes stay. My Milani Stay Put Brow Color staying. My wax from Eyelure is staying. This one, this is the Maybelline Brow Precise Fiber Filler, and I have not used this at all. At all. So I'm letting this stay because I really like to have some progress on this one. This one. This is my most loved eye primer, and this is from Essence. I really, really love this, but I'm going to take it out for now and give it a break because this is almost empty. I think I have around here or something, so I've used this a ton, but I'm going to take it out and put in another primer for now, but yeah, I love this so freaking much. H&M Eye Color To Go. I'm going to let this stay because I used this with my pigment, so staying. This Michelin Smooth Lip Liner. I really, really like this, and I have used this quite a bit, so I'm going to pull it out. Colourpop Glossy Lip in the shade Aquarius. I'm letting this stay because I love this color so much, and this is a perfect color for every day. Then I got these two. This is my little e.l.f. Brightening eyeliner in the shade Coffee. I cannot see the name on it anymore because it's rubbed off, but I'm using this for my brows, and this is in my mini matte project pan, so this is staying. This one, this is the Max Factor Cold Pencil. This went missing about a month ago, and I didn't know where it was until I took this up and it was laying right underneath. So yeah, I found it and I'm going to pull this in again because I really need to work on this one. I don't use liner for my waterline or my tight lining every day, but I really like to try to do it. So I'm just going to put all the stuff back in this little basket and then I'm going to put the new stuff in. By the way, we got the palettes. This is my Stila Eyes Out of Windows in the shade Spirit. I have used this quite a bit, and I have used this and this and this mainly, and some of the lighter shade right here. I'm going to take this out for now because I really like to have something else to work on. And then we got my Suvia Camo Melange palette. This is my Project Pan palette, so I'm just letting this stay. And all my palettes had a new home right up there. I found a little place for them, so that is perfect. Alright, let's just took the camera up a little bit so you can see everything, so I don't feel like I'm all the way down here, but I can have something here. First up is primer. I got this NYX Angel Velvet Primer. I'm putting this in. And then I'm going to take my CoverGirl Outlast All Days The Fabulous Foundation. I really, really like this foundation. For powder, I got these two. I got my Bare Minerals Powder in the shade Matte Matte and Glow Brilliant. This is just a duo, and this is the matte side, and then we got the shimmery side. And I don't know if you can see this at all. You can probably not see it. Along with my Maybelline Fit Me powder in the shade 05 Fair, I really need to have a colored powder, so that is why I'm putting this in. I'm just going to take my setting spray right now. This is my Wet n Wild Photo Focus setting spray. We're just staying in the face area For blush, I got my Maybelline Pure Blush Mineral in the shade Peachy Quartz. I really, really like this, and this is a loose powder. This is almost empty. I don't know if you have any idea, but yeah, this is almost empty, so I really like to work on this one. Then I got this one. This is the Tarte Party Amazon Clay 12 Hour Blush, and this is such a stunning color. A perfect peachy mauve shade, and I really, really like this. Then we got this one. This is my Mannekadara bronzer and highlighting duo, and I really, really, really like this. I have used this quite a bit. I don't know if you can tell, but this is such a stunning duo. I don't know if you can see that. Maybe the highlighter cannot see that, but I'm just going to do this. I don't know if you can see it. Oh yeah, right there. This is such a stunning natural combo, so I really like that. And last but not least, I got this sleek makeup. This is the face contour kit, pressed powder and highlighter in one, and this is the shade right there. I love this duo, so I'm going to pull this in as well. All right, eyes. First up, primer. I got this Urban Decay eyeshadow primer potion in original. I don't know how I feel about this, because I can remember last time I used it, I was not a big fan of it, so I will give it another go. I don't like the color of it, because it doesn't have any color, and in the Essence one, it has some color, so I really need to get on this. For eyeshadow, I got this little eyeshadow. This is a ribbon eyeshadow from Dior. This is how it looks like. I have pan on this, but I really need to work this out of my collection. Eyeshadow palette. I got this eyeshadow palette in my goodie bag, and this is from La Vici. This is new, and I am not a big fan of this palette, because the color seems really, really patchy and not pigmented, and this palette is falling apart. I don't know if you can see this at all, but yeah, this eyeshadow right here is moving. So this is a really cheap palette. This is around, maybe I can count, maybe around $40 or something. And yeah, you can hear this is not a quality palette, but I will give it a go and see if I like it or not. But I'm not a positive about this right now. But on the other hand, we're going to take a palette I love so much. This is the Morphe in collab with Kathleen Light. And I love the palette so much, because this is a perfect palette for spring and winter. I really, really like this, because it got some neutral colors right here and then some berry colors. This is such a perfect palette to have on the go, so I'm going to pull this in and hopefully get some good use out of this. And then we're going to take two single Colourpop eyeshadow. This in the shade Cornelius. I really, really like this. This is the matte, and this is also from the Cats and Lies collab, so that is perfect. And then we got this in Puppy Love. This is such a cute name, and the color is stunning. This is a more metallic shade, and I don't know if you can see it. Oh, I'm such a dog at this angle. I don't know. Oh yeah, right there. I don't know if you can see that. Okay, you know what I mean, but this is such a stunning color, and I really, really like it. And I'm going to use this for highlighting my brow bone, my inner corner, my face, everything. And I have already hit pan on this one, so I really hope I can use it up, maybe. For mascara, I'm going to pull in my Voluminous Last Paradise mascara from L'Oreal, and hopefully get some good use out of this. Alright, then we got lips, and I know this is maybe a little bit crazy. I'm going to reorganize this a little bit. Alright, let's just reorganize a little bit, because I don't have too many single eyeshadow this time. So I have an extra space right here for some of my smaller sizes, so that is why I just look a little bit empty here. But we are going to move on to the lips, and I got plenty of lip products, because I always find myself reaching for my colors in my drawer instead of this one, so I need to have some more colors in here so I don't go over to my Alex drawer and pull the colors over there. So first up, I'm going to take this Gloss lipstick in the shade Antique. This is such a stunning brown color. I'm just going to swatch it. It's right there. I really, really like this color, so I'm going to pull this in. Then I'm going to pull in my Essence Matte 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 long-lasting lip gloss in the shade Beauty Approved, and that is the shade right there, along with my ColourPop Ultra Glossy Lip in the shade Fairy Flush. This is such a stunning color. This is a more everyday color for me, and I really, really like the color of this, so I really hope I can get some good use out of that. And then I'm going to take this Sea Bad Lippy Stick in, because this is a little bit old and I need to work this out of my collection. It is right there. Such a stunning new color. Sometimes I can find this a little bit too light on me, so that is why I got this one. This is my Gloss Lip Liner in the shade Angel Kiss. And this is such a stunning color. It's making my other lip color right here just a little bit more deeper. And my way to use this is this lip liner first, and then I got my Sea Bad Lippy Stick on top, and then I'm topping that sometimes with my Aquarius lip gloss. I love that combo. This is such a pretty combo. Then we got a pop of color, and this is my ColourPop Lippy Stick in the shade Pack Pack. This is such a stunning violet, deep violet color, almost brown violet color. It's right there. I really, really like it. And just to make it more fun, I'm going to pull this in. This is my L'Oreal lip paint in the shade Wandering Purple. And yeah, I know this is maybe a little bit intense, but on top of this, this is perfect. I don't know if you can see it, but that is so pretty. And on its own, it looks like this. So it's not that vibrant on top of the other, but on its own, it's really vibrant. And last but not least, we got this Manacadar Beauty Simple Lip Locking Priming Gloss Stain Step 3, and this is in the shade Lucky. I got this in my goodie box, and this is such a pretty rosy color. I really, really like this, so I really hope I can get some good use out of this. This is right there. So yeah, that was everything for my basket. And yeah, now this is looking crazy, so I need to reorganize this. But this is everything for my monthly makeup drawer, and I'm so, so excited to have some new product to play with and some oldie but a goodie. So yeah, I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget, I love you, and then I'll see you in my next video. Bye.